purvam aparam
pradeya purvam aparam
nashta janma smriti stata
nashta janma smriti stata
yatagyastamasa
yatagyastamasa
upaste vyaktameva hi
upaste vyaktameva hi
na veda purvam aparam
na veda purvam aparam
nashta janma smriti stata. Translation: as a person in a dream while sleeping acts according to the body manifested in his dream, or accepts the body as himself, similarly, he identifies the present body as himself, which was acquired on account of past religious or irreligious life, and is not able to know of his past or future life.
যথাগস্তমসা উপাস্তি বক্তমেব হি ন বেদ পূর্বম অপরম নষ্ট জন্ম স্মৃতিস্তথা. দিস ইজ আওয়ার পজিশন, দিস ইজ আওয়ার অ্যাডভান্সমেন্ট অফ সায়েন্স, দ্যাট উই ডু নট নো হোয়াট আই ওয়াজ বিফোর দিস লাইফ and what I shall become after this life. Life is continuous. That is spiritual knowledge. They do not know also even that life is continuous. They think, by chance I have got this life and it will be finished after death. There is no question of past, present and future. Let us enjoy. This is called ignorance, tamasha, irresponsible life. So, agya means one who has no knowledge. And who has no knowledge? Tamasa, those who are in the modes of ignorance. There are three kinds of material nature modes: sattva, raja, tamas. Satagun means everything is clear, prakash, just like now the sky is covered with cloud, the sunshine is not clear. But above the cloud there is sunshine, everything clear. And within the cloud there is not clear. Similarly, those who are in the satogun, for them everything is clear. And those who are in the tamogun, everything is ignorance. And those who are mixed up, neither rajogun, neither tamogun, via media, they are called rajogun, three gunas, tamasa. So they are simply interested in the present body. Does not care what is going to happen, and has no knowledge what he was before. There is another place it is described, nunam pramatta kurute vikarma. Pramatta is like madman. He does not know why he has become mad, he forgets. And by his activities, why to what is going to happen next, he does not know. Madman. So this civilization, modern civilization, is just like madman civilization. They have no knowledge of past life, neither they are interested in the future life. Nunam pramatta krute vikarma. And fully engaged in sinful activities. Because they have no knowledge of the past life. Just like a dog Why he has become dog, that he does not know. And what he is going to have next. A dog might have been in his past life the prime minister. But when he gets the dog's life, he forgets. That is also another influence of Maya. Prakhyapatmika Shakti, Avaranatmika Shakti. Maya has got two potencies. If somebody for his past sinful activities has become a dog, and if he remembers that I was prime minister, now I have become dog, it will be impossible for him to leave. Therefore, Maya covers his knowledge. Mṛtyu means forgetting everything. That is called mṛtyu. So, that we have got experience every day and night. When at night we dream in a separate atmosphere, separate life, we forget about this body. That I am lying down, my body is lying down in a very nice apartment, nice building. No. Suppose he is loitering on the street or he is on the hill. So he's taking in dream, he's taking everyone, we take interest of that body. We forget the past body. So this is ignorance. See, ignorance, the more we become elevated from ignorance to knowledge, that is success of life. And if we keep ourselves in ignorance, that is no success. That is spoiling the life. So our Kṛṣṇa consciousness movement is to raise a person from ignorance to knowledge. That is the whole scheme of Vedic literature, to deliver a person. Kṛṣṇa says in the Bhagavad Gita about the devotees, not for all. Tīsāṁ aham samuddhatyā mittu saṁsāra sāgarāt. Another, tīsāṁ ivānukam pārtham aham agyāna jangatama nāsvayāmi ātma-bhāvastha jñāna-dīpena bhāsata. For special, for the devotees, he is situated in everyone's heart. But a devotee who is trying to understand Kṛṣṇa, he helps. He helps. To the non-devotees, they have no concern with it. They are just like animal, eating, sleeping, sex life and defense. They do not care for anything to understand God, His relationship with God. For them, they think there is no God, and Kṛṣṇa also says, yes, there is no God, you sleep, that's all. Therefore, satsanga required. This satsanga, satang prasangat, by the association of devotee, we awaken our inquisitiveness about God. Therefore, the centers are required. It is not unnecessarily we are opening so many centers. No, it is for the benefit of the human society. You can apply. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's mission is that paropakar. Benefit of the human society. all living entities within this material world, they are in ignorance. All 8,400,000 different forms of life. Just nearby, come near, yes. This is specially meant for driving the flies. Yes, this chamar is meant for that. Even it is touching body, there is no heart. So, all living entities, they are agya, they forgot. What is the value of life? So in the human form of life, where there is chance of getting the real light, if they spoil in this way, like cats and dogs, the whole world, what is the position of the world? Very precarious condition. So paropakar, therefore, those who have got enlightenment, they should try to raise these rascals who are in ignorance. That is Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's mission. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu therefore says, Bharat bhumite manusya janma haila jar. Anyone who has taken birth in Bharatvarsha, India, as human being, not cats and dogs. Janma sarthak kari, first of all make your life successful, then paropakar, then distribute the knowledge. This is Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's mission. How, why he is chasing an Indian? Because it is in India you will find these shastras, the Bhagavad Gita and Srimad Bhagavatam and many others, not in other places. The four Vedas, then the explanation of the Vedas, Upanishad, the summarization of the Vedas, Vedanta Sutra, then historically explanation, Puranas, then actual history, Mahabharata, Ramayana. So these things are available in India. And one should take advantage of the Shastra and make his life successful and then preach all over the world. So in this parampara system, this knowledge has come to your country, America, you are intelligent, you are prosperous, so take this knowledge seriously and at least distribute this knowledge properly for the benefit of your people. Otherwise, the world is in very, very precarious condition, and although the human form of life is obtained for the success of life, they are being kept purposefully or ignorantly in darkness. So, navaida purvam aparam nasta janma smritis tatha. Just like Bharat Maharaj, he was a great devotee, but somehow or other he was very much attached to one small deer. He had to accept the body of a deer. But he did not forget about his last birth. That is special prerogative for advanced devotees. Nature's law is that at the time of death, what you think, you get the body. That is nature's law. Prakritik janga vapi smarana bhavam tajattanti kalevanam, Krishna says. So we have to train up our bhava, our thoughts. If we keep always in Krishna thoughts, then naturally at the time of death we may remember Kṛṣṇa. That is success. Then immediately, taktade hang punarjanma naiti mamiti, immediately you are transferred to the Kṛṣṇa loka. And according to your desire, you become amongst the gopis or the cowherd's boys or the cows and the calves. They are all equal. There is no, that is spiritual world. Here, there is difference between the man, woman, cows or trees or flowers. No, in the spiritual world, there is no such difference. The flower is also devotee, living. The flower wants to serve Kṛṣṇa as flower. The calf wants to serve Kṛṣṇa as calf. The gopis want to serve Kṛṣṇa as gopi. They are all the same, but according to varieties. Yesterday I was speaking of the variety. Varieties of desires to serve Kṛṣṇa. So, that is spiritual world. And material world, the same varieties are there, imitation, but everyone wants to satisfy sense gratification. There is no desire for serving Kṛṣṇa. That is the difference between material world and spiritual world. In the spiritual world, all the varieties are there and they are all spirit. There is no touch of matter. They are all conscious. When the flower is there in the hand of Kṛṣṇa, the lotus, he is conscious, he is enjoying that I wanted to serve Kṛṣṇa as flower, now I am enjoying. That is spiritual. They are all conscious. So, in this way, we shall keep ourselves always Kṛṣṇa conscious. Then, even though we fall down, just like Bharat Maharaj fell down, he lost one birth, he became too much attached to that animal. He forgot his daily routine work. The description is there in the, I think, which canto? Fifth canto. He became always attached to that. Therefore, the nature's punishment was that he had to accept the body of a deer, but he was conscious. Not that Nastajanma Smriti. He did not forget what he was. He understood that I was engaged in advancing spiritual consciousness, and necessarily I became attached to this animal. Now I have got this animal body. So he was keeping himself always with the devotees. That was his advantage. Then the next life, he again took birth in a Brahmin family and he remained just like a doll. He was very much afraid to mix with the society so that he may not be misled. Therefore his name was Jadavara. Jar means dull. People used to think him as the dull-headed fool. But he was conscious of his position. He kept himself like that. Then Rahugan, the king Rahugan, understood that he is keeping himself as dull, but he is most intelligent, advanced in spiritual consciousness. And there was talk. So, in next part, Bharat Maharaj, Jada Bharat, got his salvation. So, we shall be very much cautious so that we do not forget our responsibility. Nastra Janma Smriti, it is not good. Nastra Janma, we must be responsible that we have got this birth. Labdhya Sudurlavam Idam Bahusambhavan. After many, many births, after much suffering in so many species of life, one after another, one after another. Unfortunately, the people are so dull-headed, they do not care for it. But this is the most important subject matter of life. Those who are devotees of Kṛṣṇa, they should take charge. These rascals are suffering. Let them have some idea about Kṛṣṇa. That is wanted. This is Kṛṣṇa consciousness movement. So I am very glad that you are seriously interested and Kṛṣṇa is pleased upon you and that you are sincerely trying. I can understand from these Tulsi plants. Yes, this is the practical demonstration. Unless there is bhakti, the Tulsi plant will not grow. We must be very much thankful to our Govinda Dasi. He, first of all, cultivated the Tulsi plant in Hawaii. Now our Tulsi plant is distributed. She has done a great service. I think I gave her the seeds and she very nicely done it. Now everywhere we see Tulsi plants. It is very pleasing. So, the same thing, deity worship and watering the Tulsi plants, chanting 16 rounds at least, and observing the rules and regulations, regulative principle, then your life is successful. Don't neglect. Very seriously continue. And in this one life, you are going back to home, back to garden. It is sure. I am not flattering you. Kṛṣṇa says, Manmanā bhavad bhakto majjāji māṁ namaskar. Māṁ eva iṣyasi asaṁsaya. Asaṁsaya, without any doubt, simply following these rules and regulations. Māṁ eva iṣyasi, you will come back to me. So take these words of Kṛṣṇa, Guru Kṛṣṇa. The Guru will also the same thing what Kṛṣṇa has said, and follow the principles, your life is successful. Now this place I see, although I have not seen all, is a nice place. And the grihasthas may come here, have some small cottage and grow your own food grains, vegetables, and have your cow's milk, get nice foodstuff, save time. Why should you go in the city 100 miles in car and again 100 miles come back and take unnecessary trouble? Stick to this spot and grow your own food, your own cloth, and live peacefully, save time, chant Hare Krishna. Very nice program. This is actual life. What is this nonsense life? Big cities and always people busy. If he wants to see one friend, he has to go 30 miles. If he has to see a physician, he has to go 50 miles. If he has to go to work, another 100 miles. What is this life? This is not life. Be satisfied. The devotee's life should be jāvadattha-prayajanam. We require material necessities as much as it is required. No artificial life. That is spiritual life. Simply increasing artificial life, even for saving a big machine, is required. What is this? Simply wasting time. Devil's workshop. Make life very simple. And simple living, high thinking. And always conscious to go back to home, back to Krishna. That is life. Not this life. That simply machine, 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 machine. So if you show a practical example that how you are living a simple life and how you are advanced in Krishna consciousness, then people will learn from you. You American people, if you show example, people will try to follow you and they will be happy. So I'm very glad to see this form. Develop it nicely, live peacefully, and chant Hare Krishna. Thank you very much.
Jai. 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 Jai.